me, Nutritious for Your Head. Well, it's the 25th episode, and winter has arrived. And believe you me, when you're as far north as I am in BC, Canada, when winter arrives, it really arrives. As such, I'm staying to hell inside and reviewing a rather different kind of biography called Diary of a Sick Chick, A Year in the Life of a Chronically Ill Woman, written by Sonya Dickerson. This biography is different in that rather than talking about her entire life, this book chronicles the time of her life and when she first learns that she has lupus up until now. It also has a few entries from her friends and her family as she discusses the difficulties and her experiences in dealing with this chronic illness called lupus. Lupus is a systemic autoimmune disease which, like AIDS, turns our immune system against us. However, unlike AIDS, it's not an STD, and there's still a lot of mystery surrounding how it comes about. It seemingly strikes at random, regardless of one's age, biological sex, or their race. It also attacks women more than men, and people of color more than white people. All in all, this book was really rather short for reading time, clocking in at about 5 hours, but the impact it had was very powerful. Sonya is able to describe the pain that she feels during the worst of the flares of lupus in a manner that's very explicit, and I had to put the book down numerous times because that description was really rather disturbing. And it's meant to be. Sonya does not spare the feelings of the reader when she talks about what it's like to live with this disease. In as frank and as honest a manner as possible, she details how draining lupus can be, as well as the difficulties she has in dealing with doctors that are meant to be there to help her. The other thing I took away from this book is the sheer amount of ableism that Sonya and others like her, people who suffer from chronic illnesses, face nearly every day. There are more than a few sections in this book in which she will receive advice from everyone that range from complete strangers to family to more complete strangers, telling her that she'll get better if only she does one of the following. Think positive. Exercise. Diet more. Eat this new awesome diet based on yogurt. Eat this new awesome diet based on nothing but vegetables. Become a vegan. Exercise some more. Drink urine. Take lots and lots of vitamins. Stop taking all those drugs that just barely keep you functioning in spite of the constant destroying pain you're feeling. It's really indicative of Western society how this ableism seems to come out without any thought whatsoever. As though the people are wondering just what it is that others have done in order to contract such a chronic illness, when such things happen almost completely at random. I once read, although I wish I remembered where, that it's based off the idea that bad things happen only to bad people, so that when bad things happen to good people, everyone is baffled. Not that it matters to some of the people who Sonya has spoken with, some of whom have said really appalling things to her, as though her very status of being a black woman with a chronic illness invites such words, such as this gem, taken from the section, My Life in a Wheelchair. Anyone in a wheelchair could tell you stories for days of rude people, curious children, falls, scrapes, and countless other war stories from the use of a wheelchair. But the one that affected me the most was a co-worker's words. She was well regarded among her peers. She always had a kind word and an inspirational Bible scripture to share with anyone. She approached me and told me something that I still struggle with today. She told me that if I had faith in God, I would be able to walk on my own without a wheelchair. I was flabbergasted, confused, angry, and sad all at once. This woman knew nothing of my situation, but felt compelled to let me know that my lack of faith in God led me to where I am today. How best shall I express my reaction to this complete bit of asshattery? Oh, I know.
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
You have to be one really judgmental piece of shit in order to lob off something like that to someone who's a complete stranger. Frankly, she had to have been riding so goddamn high on her horse that I'm amazed she got any oxygen to her damn head in the first place. And if judgmental pricks weren't enough, Sonya also details the difficulties she has in dealing with doctors who are more interested in reading books, graphs, and charts than they are in listening to their patients. This leaves Sonya dealing with crippling pain, sometimes for months at a time, before she's prescribed the right drug or given the right treatment in order to deal with some new twist that Lupus throws at her completely at random. And these frustrations are not relegated to only heartless pricks and book-strict doctors, but in how Lupus impacts all areas of her life, such as her responsibilities as a bus driver, as a mother, and at the time of the book's release, a fiancé. Lupus is a disease that does not let up, and is a daily struggle in order to get up in the morning, even at its lowest levels. Finally, we are left with the message that for however much of a warrior Sonya is in dealing with this disease, in struggling to understand it and spread awareness of it, in the end, she's only human. And that means that every now and then she has to just lay down, take a break, and rest. The lessons that I took from this book was that not only should I have a greater compassion for those who have a chronic illness, but that whatever I can do tomorrow, I should do today. After all, we have no idea what tomorrow will bring with us, who will be taken with us, and who will remain, and what can be taken from us, be it our mental, physical, or emotional health. So if you can do it today, do it. I'm Triple J, and that's all I got left to say. Take care.
Dry white ocean.